All right, well, more than 300,000 Australians have had their personal information stolen after lender Latitude Financial was hit in what's being described as a sophisticated, malicious cyber attack. To discuss, we're joined by Alistair McGibbon, Chief Strategy Officer at CyberCX in Melbourne, whose company has recently worked with Latitude Financial. Thanks so much for your time. Now, over 100,000 copies of customers' ID were stolen, 97% being driver's licences, plus 225,000 customer records. After everything we've seen lately, how does this happen?
Typically, the company is tricked into letting someone inside, perhaps by the outsider stealing a password or impersonating someone. Like at the moment, I'm impersonating Alistair McGibbon. And once inside, if the data's not sufficiently secure, then people can just wander around and find it. It is the easy way of getting in. Sometimes there are technically sophisticated attacks, but usually it's as simple as that.
Hang on, who are you then?
I'm Professor Richard Buckland from the University of New South Wales, but honoured to be seen to be Alistair McGibbon, who is a wonderful man.
Very sorry about that. We had a mix-up there in our introduction. My apologies. Now, after a major data breach against Optus and Medibank, it's clear that this is still work needed.
Yeah, absolutely. Both from a regulatory point of view, the government's doing a review at the moment and looking for suggestions for how they can have carrots and sticks to encourage companies to improve their cybersecurity and for companies themselves to improve their cybersecurity. Until that happens, we're just sitting ducks.
Yeah, absolutely. There is a lot of work that needs to be done. Thanks so much for your time. Apologies about
no
that
worries.
Again, Carl.
Cyber attacks.
We've been hacked ourselves, right?
The Russian jets.
Russians, Sarah.
Anyway, who knows what's going to happen in the last hour and a half of our show.